स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एनसीईआरटी मित्र। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो यू स्टार्टेड ए न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज द नेचुरल वेजिटेशन ऑफ इंडिया। देयर यू डिस्कस्ड ए लॉट ऑफ थिंग फैक्ट्स, इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स रिगार्डिंग द इंडियन नेचुरल फॉरेस्ट और नेचुरल वेजिटेशन। देयर यू डिस्कस ए लॉट ऑफ थिंग। देन यू डिस्कस ऑल्सो द वॉट इज नेचुरल वेजिटेशन, परहैप्स यू कैन सी इन माई बैकग्राउंड। And as well, you discuss the types of the natural vegetation. There you discuss a lot of things, forest, grassland, desert area, all these things you discuss. Now we are in this video, we are going to discuss the types of the natural vegetation and their location. In first type of natural vegetation, perhaps you can see in this diagram, that is the tropical rainforest. Tropical rainforest also known as the tropical wet evergreen forest. Okay, why it is the wet evergreen? Wet means the throughout the year soil get the moisture, soil have the moisture, and trees or the natural vegetation get this. So that's why it is the natural wet. Okay, and evergreen, this type of trees never shed the leaves throughout the year. Okay, and these are the area where the rainfall, you can see, perhaps you can see, exist more than 250 centimeter annual rainfall. Annual temperature, perhaps you can see 25 to 27 degrees centigrade. Okay, so centigrade temperature, annual average or the annual humidity that not exist, you can say the 77%. So dry season is the distinctly short. So there, this area means the western ghat or western side of the western ghat, northeast India, this area is considered as that type of vegetation, full of that type of vegetation. If you want to discuss the characteristic, perhaps you can see that is the evergreen. Due to the high heat and the high humidity, perhaps you can see that is the trees are the, those forests are never shed the leaves throughout the years. Okay, mesophytic, if one of the plants adapted is neither too dry and neither too hot. Okay, so this thing we have to understand. Second thing, perhaps you can see lofty, the trees often reach 45 to 60 meters in, you can say, centimeter. Thick canopy from the air. The tropical rainforest appears like a thick canopy, or the, you can say, the broken, only the crossed or the large river is can be found. So if there is a large river in between the river, you can, one gap must be there, otherwise the thick forest or canopy forest you can find over. All plant struggle upwards, means, and to get the sunlight, and that give the, you can say, the umbrella type of vegetation cover all over that area. If you visit in Amazon, in the wild basis, I'm telling, if you visit in the southern India, in the western Ghat, so there you can find the canopy type of vegetation, you can find. Okay, epiphyte, most of there is a struggle upwards. Epiphyte means a struggle upwards to get the sunlight, because without sunlight, they cannot produce the food. Okay, so this thing, less undergrowth. Undergrowth is very less because sunlight cannot see. Without sunlight, any plant, it may be the grass, it may be the anything, cannot be grown. Okay, most of the trees, you can see that the underground trees are the most of them, the bamboos, ferns, climbers, some of the climbers and orchards you can find over there. Distribution, where you can find in this type of vegetation, western side of the western Ghat, where the most of the sea level or 500 to 1300 meters above the west sea level. Okay, so this thing we have to understand. Second thing, the region of the Purvanchal. Purvanchal means the northeast India, the seven sister states, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura, then come to the Arunachal Pradesh, then come to the southern portion of the Arunachal Pradesh, then come to the Meghalaya, Assam. So these are the area, that is the Purvanchal hills we can find over there. Mizo, Garo, Khasi, then come to Naga. Okay, so these are the hills, Jayantia. Andaman and Nicobar is also, you can find this type of vegetation. So that's why it is too much important. There you can see the timber, it is a very, very hardwood. Why? This area gets the, and very, very wet actually. The weight of this hard is very, very much, very much. Why it is that? Because this area gets the highest rainfall. Perhaps you can see tropical type of rainforest, you can see western Ghat of western side and northeast India. And this area is very, very much famous for that type of vegetation. It is high commercial value, but it is highly challenging to exploit due to the dense underground and absence of the pure stands and lack of, you can say, transport facilities and taiga, etc. Okay, so these are the main area. Taiga is the northern India and northern hemisphere. Okay, another thing that the important trees, perhaps you can see, that is the mahogany, ओके मैं स्वादेन कम टू द महुआ देन आई कैन से द आपने वाइट वाइट सीडर जामुन ओके कैंस एंड बैम्बूस सो दिस आर द ट्रीज यू कैन फाइंड इन दैट एरिया परहैप्स यू कैन सी इन माय बैकग्राउंड आई हैव सीन द फॉरेस्ट इन इंडिया दे आर ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट द डीप यू कैन से द डीप ग्रीन कलर सो द व्हाट एवर यू कैन फाइंड सो दिस आर द एरिया वेयर यू कैन फाइंड दिस टाइप ऑफ फॉरेस्ट ओके सो दिस आर द This also can be divided into the semi-evergreen forest. What is the semi-evergreen forest? They are the transitional forest between the tropical evergreen forest and tropical deciduous forest. Means one area is finished, that is the tropical evergreen, and after to wait forest, after that you can find the tropical deciduous forest. Okay, so this thing we have to find out. They are the comparatively dry areas and the wet of evergreen forest. Climatic condition, what is the annual climatic, you can say the annual rainfall is 200 centimeter to 250 centimeter in between. Okay, mean annual temperature varies from the 24 to 27 degree centigrade. Relative humidity perhaps you can see the 75 centimeters. Okay, and the dry season is not, it may be vary from in on your book actually, not short in the tropical evergreen forest, where you can find western coast, Assam, lower slope of the eastern Himalayas, Odisha and Andaman. These are the area where you can find this type of semi-evergreen forest. So it is the transitional zone between the tropical wet forest and the tropical deciduous forest. Okay. Characteristics, semi, you can see the characteristic, you can find dense forest, you can find over there. Less, you can see the gregarious forest, you can find. And this forest are characterized by the many species. This is usually is the buttressed, you can see the buttressed and trunk abundantly. Okay, APAP files. So these are the forest. Here you can see some of the diagram I have shown here only. That can you can see in this area is very, very much important for that region. Okay. So this much for today about the tropical evergreen forest. Our next slide will discuss the tropical deciduous forest, desert forest, etc. Thank you for watching this.